So this is it. We're here. We're parked in the Disneyland Paris car park. We've managed to get ourselves somewhere in the B section, the Bambi section, which is still quite close considering it's quite late in the day. It seems fairly quiet here. There was lots of the parking spaces that were closed off. I'm assuming that's to stop people using the far away ones too soon, but I don't really know. We're just going to double check exactly where we are, and we're going to make our way into the Disneyland Park. Worth noting for a minute, normally you've got travelators here, which you can see just on my right hand side over here. They're actually closed at the moment. If you're coming right now, and I don't know how long they're going to be closed for, be prepared, you still have to walk into the park, even if you're parked really far away.
You're meant to have fun.
I told a lie, because some of them are open. We had to get all the way down to the middle of Bambi, but the travelator is open. So this is a great tip for many people that are coming to Disneyland. You need one of these. This is my phone. So on my phone, I've got two very important things done. The first thing is I've downloaded the Disneyland Paris app. If you've ever been to Disneyland in Florida or California, it is a different app from there. So do not think that it's the same one. It's a different app entirely. I've also added my Magic Pass to my Apple Wallet. So if I scroll through, and here I know I'm looking down, there is my Magic Pass on my phone ready to use to scan in at the park. So make sure that A, you've got the app for Disneyland Paris, which means that you can check the times while you're in there, and make sure you've got your passes saved onto your phone. Coming up to the Disney parks, you can see a lot of construction wall on the left hand side because they are expanding part of the Disneyland parks in Paris at the moment, looking to make the new Frozen area and expanding the Pixar area. Where even though you can see the Hollywood Tower Hotel and the entrance to Walt Disney Studios straight ahead of us, we're actually going to be going into Walt Disney Park to start our time here in Paris. So there it is, we've come around the corner and Disneyland Paris entrance is now right in front of us. This is going to be the security entrance to the park. So let's get ourselves in, get our bags checked and see what we're going to do first. So we've all gotten ourselves through security, no problems first time. You just put your bags through an x-ray scanner and make sure you put anything like phones and things on the side to get you through. No problems with us this time. We're going straight now into the Disneyland Park. Oh, look at that. That's amazing, isn't it? So even though we've just got here, most people might go for a ride first, but it's, it's 12:05 and most of us haven't really eaten since 2 o'clock this morning. So we're gonna go get something to eat. There's the castle! It's a castle. So we're just walking down Main Street. We're gonna get some food and we are going right here to Casey's Corner. So we're here in Casey's Corner, we're gonna order ourselves some food. So Tracy and I are gonna share one of the nacho hot dogs. All of us is gonna have one of the classic hot dogs with no sauces on it, just to see what that is like. And the girls are gonna share some of their nuggets to see what they are like. So we've finished our quick food in Casey's Corner, and I'll talk about that in a different video, but suffice to say, we all ate pretty well. We walked straight out of Casey's Corner and we sat ourselves down on Main Street because we're gonna enjoy a million splashes of color, the parade here at Disneyland Paris. It's got to be said, no matter what Disney park you're at, they know how to do a parade. Lots and lots of really cool characters, great dancing people, and a good crowd following them as well. That was well worth hanging around for, and we were really lucky to get a really good spot in the middle of Main Street to see that as well. I really hope you enjoyed the little snippets that I got into that video. We just had a quick look. We're going to do a quick character meet and greet. We're going to go and see Winnie the Pooh, mainly because my wife has got a Winnie the Pooh bag. There is that said bag. So yeah, let's go and meet Winnie the Pooh. That was great. We waited like 50 minutes, but it was well worth it. Winnie the Pooh was great. Some amazing interactions, and he was great fun. The girls managed to get some signatures, and we managed to use our photo pass for the first time. We're having a quick walk over now to the Disneyland Railroad, because we're going to take the train. So this is just a beautifully themed old style railway station with a steam train. It's a nice, really relaxed sit down attraction where if you want to take the weight off your feet for a little while, you can. We've got probably about a 10 minute wait here while the next train arrives. Big thunder. Yep. So after a very relaxing sit down on that train, you have some great views of lots of different things around the park, including some unique views of Pirates of the Caribbean, going past Hyperspace Mountain, and lots of others as well. We're now going to take a 5 minute walk over to Fantasyland for the simple reason that the ride we're going to go on has only a 5 minute wait, and because if you're in Disney, have you actually been here? If you haven't been on a Small World, there are some beautiful statues here at Disneyland Paris. Not least, this is got to be one of my favorites. It's Baymax. Everybody loves a Baymax. So It's a Small World is a classic Disney dark ride. If you've ever been on either of the ones in America, you'll know it is generally used to get out the heat, as well as getting some sit down. We're just going to use it for a sit down, and because, well, Small World at Disney. So after a little sit down on It's a Small World, it's time to go for a walk around the Alice in Wonderland maze. Let's see if we can get lost, and if we don't, then maybe we'll find Alice or a white rabbit. Let's find been in here 2 minutes and we've lost everybody else already. I don't know where...
Ah, we have found you again.
So after Alice, we're going to bring a little bit of competition into our day and enjoy a bit of a sit down. It's really busy down by the castle right now because there's a show going on in the Central Plaza. So we are heading to Buzz Lightyear over in Discoveryland for a bit of family competition. Okay, jumping into Buzz Lightyear Laser Blast. The app says 30 minute wait, and there's a 30 minute wait up there. Let's see how long we actually end up waiting.
I will remain here at Star Command to coordinate the mission. Battle stations, report to the flight deck for immediate launch to infinity and beyond.
I really do love playing that game. There is one flaw. I suck at it. Well, there you go, what can you do? Let's find my photo. So after a very, very long day and what's actually been a fairly leisurely walk around Disneyland Park today, we are heading back to the lodge for the end of our day. We are all bleeding knackered after our early start, but it's been a really good day. We've eaten some nice food and we've done a couple of nice attractions. So we'll be back tomorrow to lead you through day two, our first sort of full day, where we'll be taking full advantage of our magic time. We'll talk more about that in the morning. That's the last you're gonna hear from me today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please hit the like button down below and maybe subscribe to see the next videos in the series. Until then, bye for now.